Good morning, everyone. Welcome back to Family Devotions with Pastor Karen. As you can see, I'm just doing a little workout this morning, working on strength and endurance and resilience, and trying to improve my fitness a little bit. I've heard from a lot of you that you do the same thing, whether you are doing armchair exercises or taking a walk every day, bicycling, dancing, swimming, whatever it is you're doing. I know that we understand how important fitness is and how we can't just wish our way to fitness. We have to work for it. We have to do something that strengthens our bodies and increases our lung capacity and all the things that we hope to get out of whatever exercise we do so that we can be more fit and we can do the things that we want to do in our lives. Well, there is something in the scriptures that tells us about fitness. I want to share with you, this is from Colossians chapter 1, verses 9 through 12. Listen to this. Be assured that from the first day we heard of you, we haven't stopped praying for you, asking God to give you wise minds and spirits attuned to his will, and so acquire a thorough understanding of the ways in which God works. Now listen to this. We pray that you'll live well for the Master, making him proud of you as you work hard in his orchard. As you learn more and more how God works, you will learn how to do your work. We pray that you'll have the strength to stick it out over the long haul. Not the grim strength of gritting your teeth, but the glory strength God gives. It is strength that endures the unendurable and spills over into joy, thanking the Father who makes us strong enough to take part in everything bright and beautiful that he has for us. You see, there's a kind of strength that comes not from lifting weights and running and doing exercises, but the kind of spiritual strength, emotional strength that we need in order to live the life God has called us to, and even to endure through whatever life brings our way. This kind of strength comes from exercising something other than our muscles. It comes from exercising our faith. It comes from growing in our knowledge of Scripture. It comes from working out with the body of Christ, with our community of faith, gathering together as we can to serve and to do the work that God has called us to do. It comes from strengthening our inner selves through the work of the Holy Spirit, through our knowledge and understanding and study and meditation on Scripture, through worship, through prayer, through attuning ourselves, as Paul says in this verse, attuning ourselves to the Holy Spirit and to God's will. The more we attune ourselves to the will of God, the more fit we are, the stronger we are, the more equipped we are for the work of being a follower of Jesus and for being a person of faith in a world when sometimes our faith can be shaken. And when life wants to knock us down, we want to be able to endure and to respond with strength and with joy. And Paul also says that gratitude, there's that word again, gratitude is part of what spills over as we do that work of working out spiritually, of growing in our faith and in our knowledge of God. And we can't help but be grateful to God as we do those things. And that gratitude is part of the foundation of our strength. So get a good workout in today, whatever it is you're going to do. Take a beautiful walk, take a time to lift some weights or to run or to do whatever it is you do, but also build into every day your spiritual workout, your faith workout, the way that you will grow stronger in your faith as a follower of Jesus. Let's pray together. Oh Lord, we thank you for all the ways that you have given us to learn your will, to grow attuned to your spirit, to grow closer in loving relationship with you. Help us to take advantage of those every single day to grow stronger in our faith, to make ourselves fit for your kingdom, and to give us the endurance we need in all circumstances so that we can live according to your will and be a blessing to the world. Amen. See you soon, friends.